Hello everyone, this is Bobbin Threadbear, and welcome back to Brutal Legend. Now, we can't really seem to see much around Bladehenge just yet, since the game won't let us. So let's do what it does want us to.
Don't worry, we'll go free those women soon, I promise.
Every second we wait is just one more moment they spend in degradation and danger.
Real feel for you there. Anyway, let's go touch the glowing thing. Yep, this is one of the many collectibles you'll find across the landscape.
I can't wait to try that out.
In this case, it gives you a guitar solo you can play. And each guitar solo does a different thing, and in this case, it just summons the car for you. So, pretty obvious why you had to encounter it first. Oh, but here's something. Damn, it left trigger sticking again. Okay, let's try this.
Flowers are telling me that this relic needs to be raised.
Well, that's pretty explicit. So let's do that.
That's my kind of relic.
Of course, we can only get into this one while driving the car, so...
Well, it's about fucking time. Not bad. Looks like you figured out the instructions, okay? You've got some demon flesh on your bumper, but that's the way the world is today, I'm afraid.
Who?
Oh, me. Oh, I'm nobody. I'm just a guardian of metal.
Oh, wow, great.
So, you want to help me fight demons and stuff?
Nah. I'm not a fighter, I'm more of a, what should we say, a keeper of timeless secrets, that's all.
Prove yourself worthy, maybe I'll share some with you.
For instance, did you know that this world was once ruled by an ancient race of titans? Now they were something. They took every part of that old fire beast. They took his blood, his fire, his steel flesh. They even took his scream, and they made that car there, and a million other things, including music. Fucking beautiful music, man. And when they rose to the heavens and became gods, they left instructions behind. How to make cars, music, the whole deal. Do you think anybody noticed?
No.
Bunch of wankers. No one figured out any of it. Until you, whoever you are. So, you must be somewhat worthy of the gods' favor, I suppose. So listen, if you do something that pleases the gods, they might reward you. With a fire tribute, ha 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 ha. When they've paid you enough tributes, come see me. I'll share some more secrets
of metal with you.
Like, how to turn that little beast you got over there into a real monster. Among other things. Got it?
Oh, hello there, Izzy Osborne. And that is actually him, by the way, in case you were wondering, and not just an incredible imitation.
Metal noise, blood and fire, tell me what you most desire.
Huh, it's pretty catchy. It rhymes.
Yes, take care of your car.
And the first thing we get for free is the radio.
Care to make your mark on the world? Now these are a lot bigger than they look. Oh, that guy. That looks like some guy I used to know.
I don't even remember who Tim is.
How about... I've got a couple of moves I can show you. This one's a little
flat. Ah, fire!
Of course, these actually cost money, and since we have none... Oh boy.
Already got that.
Spiky. But perhaps a bit too spiky at the moment.
Maybe. Pain comes in many flavors. The way Armageddon intended.
Well, that looks just rad.
The secret of metal.
Keep the old gal in tune. These strings come with a free paint job, I should mention. Oh, the ladies love this one.
What's that even saying? This Tenacious D. Oh.
Very sexy.
Well, that explains that. Bunch of free back patches here. Cabbage Boy, that's that band at the beginning that died horribly when Armageddon came into the world.
Stop. We can buff out the scratches while we're at it.
But I think we'll take Armageddon's face. You know, they won. And Fletus, we'll be seeing him eventually.
The way Armageddon intended.
But for now, let's pay tribute to the last Double Fine game.
Wait, what do I have to do for a fire tribute?
Please the fucking gods of metal, man. Figure it out.
Right, okay. I'll be back soon, covered in metal god love.
Oh, God.
Getting some slowdown here. I'll have to turn some features off. Anyway, if you saw those little glowing pixies, if I can actually hit those things, that's actually a way to get some fire tributes. Let's try this with boosts on. Or not. Damn it. Alright, third time's the charm. Come on, down the center. Got it. Yeah, when you make certain jumps correctly, you get the lightning plugs. And gathering lightning plugs gets you 10 fire tributes. Just like... aw, oh, damn it. Hang on. Okay, this time, I'm gonna get it. Yes! 10 more fire tributes. Of course, I'm not just gonna go back and get an upgrade just right now. Still got a place to be, after all. Won't let me go just anywhere until I've done the thing. But wait, what's that? Let's have a look. Yeah, maybe you didn't spot it, but I did. It's a dragon with a great big red ball in its mouth. Yeah. That's another collectible, the Bound Serpents. There are 120 of them, and for every 10 you get like a little bonus. Along with 5 fire tributes. It's not much, but, you know, 120, it adds up. As do the minor bonuses. But now we'll do this thing that they want us to do. Damn it, not again. Stupid trigger.
In the days of darkness.
Oh, that's the song.
The sword and the lance. Nor did he.
How do you think the battle is going?
So this is it. The Crushing Pit.
Hundreds of our strongest young men toiling their lives away, like their fathers and grandfathers before them. Given no tools, forced to break solid rock with nothing but their own thick skulls.
Well, come on, let's bust them out of there. Where's the gate?
There is no gate.
What?
They have nowhere to go. No idea how to function outside the pit. Society has no use for them, so they stay underground. I wish I could help them, but I mean, what do you do with a bunch of kids who don't know how to do anything but bang their heads all day long?
You start a revolution, Lars. Right now! It's time to sound the battle cry!
Have you been looking at my sword?
I need to get back to Bladehenge before Ophelia does something dangerous.
I'll meet you back there, with an army fit for a king.
Well, Lars is going to go off and be useless, but who needs him? Got ourselves a new guitar solo.
Hey dudes! Knock it off for a second!
You don't have to be slaves!
Beat it, dirtbag!
You don't have to be slaves!
Beat it, dirtbag!
Well, that's no way to talk to Jack Black. Let's show them what they're missing out on.
Oh. Oh. What is that sound?
It's a devil screaming.
It's an angel singing.
It is the pounding of creation's hammer upon the anvil of time.
It's fucking awesome.
It's called heavy metal. And it's the real reason you should bang your heads, not for that guy.
Yeah! Screw this place!
Yeah! Let's get out of here!
Metal!
Hey, hang on, guys. I know we're all struggling right now, but I'm telling you, this is all gonna pay off really soon.
Yeah, our manager says that if we just work hard and produce a high-quality product, that we'll be able to move up to cush guard jobs in the General's Pleasure Tower.
There's gonna be piles of chicks and booze and stuff.
We're with him.
Hey man, sorry, but
we got a sweet gig here, and we're not about to let you greasebags ruin it.
Guard!
Riot!
Walk out!
Uh-oh. Bouncers.
I heard those guys over there say they're organizing a union.
We'll go sound the alarm!
Okay, dudes, don't worry. I have a plan.
Hey, did I say charge?
Man, I have wanted to do that forever.
That's for killing Charlie, you bastard!
Whoa. Hey, okay. See how much ass you dudes kick when you band together like that? That's awesome!
Now with just a little bit of practice, I bet I can turn you dudes into a well-oiled machine of death. You into it?
Yeah.
Okay, first, when I do this, it means you gotta follow me, okay? Okay, let's try it. Follow me!
Right.
That's what I'm talking about. Check. Okay. Right. Now let's practice moving.
Yeah, this is just a tutorial about how to control your followers in the RTS mode.
Hey, company boy!
Here they are!
Oh, all right, yeah. Kill him.
Earned yourself some destroy. Enjoy.
Okay, now, opposite style. When I do this, it means don't follow me. Stay put, defend this hallowed ground, got it?
Uh-huh.
Defend this pile of crap with your very lives. Okay, here we go.
This is all pretty simple stuff here.
Freeze! Gotcha.
We're like a death trap.
Really good, gotcha. You guys. Now that means stay put for real. I'm gonna go walk over there and I don't want anybody to follow me.
Oh, that purple statue.
Okay, I'm gonna turn around now. And if I see anyone following me, I'm gonna be really disappointed. Yes! You guys pass. For now. But now we gotta huddle up for the big finale. Gather round me, warriors!
Regroup!
Dude,
it's two!
Dude.
I'll put a guard in for
first to kill that statue.
I'm still ahead.
Now this time we're gonna mix it up. I'll defend this area while you dudes go kick the shit out of that statue over there.
Yeah!
Let's do it.
Okay, so when I do this, you go completely nut shit on whatever I'm pointing at, okay? Get ready?
So the nice thing about these orders is that they've actually got a pretty decent...
Go get 'em!
...radius on who they apply to.
Lion White sucks.
Death to Lion White! I hate statues!
Well done. I'm proud of you boys. But to build an army big enough to take on the real Lion White, we're gonna need some more dudes. We gotta bust all your fellow headbangers out of these stupid mines. What do you say? Are you with me?
Yeah!
Metal!
Alright, well.
Huddle up!
Let's get going.
I'm on.
Kick some ass!
Yes. Gotcha.
Nice work.
Okay,
now let's go. No headbanger left behind.
Oh, hey, it's the giant wheel of pointlessness. You know, Conan the Barbarian worked on one of those.
Master.
And he turned into Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Keep moving! Hey! No fading from the giant!
Bet we're gonna get some real strong dudes out of this one. But until then, these other guys here... well, we can use them.
Metal!
How's that feel? Like the greatest
hey,
thing that ever happened to you, right?
Well, I got a whole bunch of these dudes. Now let's get these guys in tow here.
You don't have to be slaves!
Awesome!
Yeah! You guys feeling it?
Uh-oh. Trust me! We are under attack! Crush the intruder and his band of traitors! More trustees on the floor right now!
First, let's try and get these guys on the gyre. No?
How's that feel? Like the greatest thing that ever happened?
Annihilate!
On it!
On it!
On it!
If there's anybody else I can get in here. Until then, the headbangers can fend for themselves.
Is that all you got, Mittens?
Traitors, animals, I'd rather see you dead than free. Cripple the grinding gyre. Burn the ungrateful man cubs.
What did he say?
Something about a crate full of ham hogs.
They're attacking the gyre. They're gonna drop it in the lava.
With all those dudes on it.
Okay, we have to guard all three of these gyre supports.
Hey, they're attacking that support over there!
Let's kill them all!
Alright, you can take care of the bouncers. I'll deal with these hairbangers.
They're attacking two supports at the same time!
How are they doing that?
You guys defend this support, I'll go defend the other.
Come on, just like we practiced!
Now, I'm sure they'll be fine.
Oh man, where is everybody? Am I the only one who hates this
fight?
You'll notice that the three supports are three different symbols.
Hey, you dudes over there! Come here, can't you hear me?
Well, so you can keep track of which one's being attacked, because the ones being attacked appear in red. It's actually very nice of them.
They're attacking both the supports on the far side!
Alright, you guys take one, I'll get the other!
Yeah, they
send the strikers into
the headbangers just generally go into action on their own. You don't really need to babysit them at all. Which is good, because it means that you have plenty of time to get your own hands dirty. You
betcha. Destroy!
Of course, they... not quite sure where the hell they wound up. Since they only just now managed to get to the Iron Cross support. But, whatever. We're still doing pretty fine, only the one bouncer left to deal with. They're pretty big, and they take a lot of damage, but not quite as much as you'd think.
Enough! You think you killed them all, don't you? Well, you forgot my favorites, my managers, the ones who keep all the other workers in line. The only two I know I can always count on. Fear and pain.
So, employee of the month here is basically a puzzle boss rather than a straight-up fight. You'll note that pretty much any attack he'll block. And while lightning stuns him for a second, it's not long enough for a proper strong attack from the axe. However, you also note that his shockwaves open the hoppers and make all the debris fall out on those marked yellow lines. But of course, if you think about it, Eddie Riggs has his own shockwave attack, so if you can lure him onto the yellow strip, that'll stun him for more than long enough to hit the panel on his back. And you can use the lightning to keep him still long enough to hit him in the back again. Don't know how he got out of that so quickly, but let's just do it one more time. Hit the panel twice, and he goes... over the edge.
Guards. All guards. Code red. Repeat.
Wait, there's too many!
What are we gonna do?
We're gonna need another army!
Need help! We need like a million more guys!
Eddie, we're outnumbered!
Well, we happen to have a lot more guys, and while this didn't work before...
Huh? What the...
Now have a microphone to amplify the sound.
Let's go!
Hey, what took you guys so long?
This is awesome! We should have done this years ago!
Now we just need to sit back and watch.
Listen up! In honor of you guys, we're calling this new army Ironhead. With an E on the end, so people know we're not messing around.
Ironhead.
I like it.
Right on!
I don't get it.
So let's get back to Bladehenge and get this army started!
Ironhead!
Now, it went by fast, so you might have missed it, but we also get a whole bunch of fire tributes from finishing missions. Plus, story progression gets you more items...
Raw Patrol!
...available in the Iron Forge, as it just says. And then units you pick up, you can find just sort of wandering around... ...on the open field.
Let's do that again sometime.
You can also see enemy units running around on the field. Those were hair bangers in the back there. Anyway, that's enough brutal legend for now. But before we go, it's time for my brand new segment. Bands you probably haven't heard of unless you live in Europe. Maybe. The title is self-explanatory, so let's dive right on in with our first band, Sonata Arctica. Sonata Arctica is a Finnish metal band that formed in the mid-90s, although it took them until nearly the end of 1999 to nail down their sound and come out with their first album. The band has had a relatively stable lineup over the years, at least since 2000, but the only two permanent members have been Tony Keiko on vocals and keyboards and Tommy Portimo on the drums. Sonata Arctica is best placed in the power metal genre. Now, what is power metal? Well, it's a bit hard to pin down. Mostly it's the uppers to death metal's downers. It's loud, it's exciting. Wants to make you feel better about yourself. Power metal sounds like this. That was Kingdom for a Heart, off of Sonata Arctica's first album, Ecliptica. Now, I don't mean to say that power metal can't handle serious topics. The song Replica, off the same album, deals with a soldier coming home who has PTSD, and the longest song on the album, Destruction Preventer, is about nuclear war. And that actually brings me to one of the things I really like about the band. You see, most songs you hear about relationships, you can put on a basic timeline. Is falling in love, getting together, having sex, possibly some cheating on his or her part, and then a messy breakup. Sonata Arctica, however, has a lot of songs about more unusual relationships. Like on Silence, there's the song San Sebastian, about a guy who gets to date the woman of his dreams, only to realize that she's far too much woman for him to handle. And so he has to leave her and settle for less. When Her Heart's Guild has The Misery, about an author who uses the abusive relationship he's in as an inspiration. Reckoning Night has My Selene, about a man in love with the moon who slowly loses hope for a love he can never obtain. And more recently, on The Days of Grace, there's Juliet, which imagines that Romeo was paralyzed but still alive when Juliet woke up, but he only has enough time to think, the fuck? Before dying. Over the years, Sonata Arctica has moved away from its power roots and grown darker, more progressive. And I'll talk about progressive metal in a future segment, but for now just think of it as Pink Floyd, but louder and faster. Of course, it can often be hard to track just when and how a band has changed over time, but Sonata Arctica went and made my job easier by remaking one song from each of their first two albums when they re-released them in 2008. So here's Letter to Dana from their first album. And here's that same passage in the remake. Dana O'Hara, oh Dana, my dear, how I wish that my Dana was here. Little Dana O'Hara decided one day to travel away, far away. Pretty stark. Personally, I like both versions just fine. But, to be perfectly honest, I prefer their older stuff. Still, I own 6 of their 7 studio albums, including the newest 2. All physical copies, no less. And I don't regret buying any of them. Heck, I can name a couple of standouts on each one. Replica and Kingdom for a Heart on Ecliptica, San Sebastian Revisited and Wolf and Raven on Silence, The Cage and Victoria's Secret on Winter Hearts Guild, Mycelene and White Pearl Black Ocean on Reckoning Night, Paid in Full and It Won't Fade on Unia, Death Aura and Flag in the Ground on The Days of Grace, and Alone in Heaven and Wildfire Part 2 on Stones Grow Her Name. If I had to pick just one album to recommend, I'd go with Reckoning Night. It's right in the middle of their catalog, and it has my two favorite songs by them. Thanks for listening, everyone. And remember, metal will never die.